God, we thank you for today.
We already
started preaching.
That
we're coming home
strong.
That we walk together
as we
share this
word. Your
word is life.
And we
pray for
wisdom
hidden in the word.
Let it
be manifested unto our lives in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Give
the Holy Spirit a hand. Praise
the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's just a song, it's something that
Masquire
sang a song that I've kept your word
in my heart so
that I don't go astray. Praise the Lord.
So
the word of God,
if
you keep it and you meditate
in it and you
walk your life in it,
everything
is going to be easy for you.
Because
if you live in the word, you are in spirit. Praise the Lord. If you keep the word in the heart,
you
have put the Holy Spirit in your
word,
in your heart. Amen.
And
any action that you
do
for that word of God to keep it,
because
it helps you not to sin. For example, you were a forgiver and you accepted the word of God that says do not commit any sexual immorality. Remember, immorality, if you repent it,
it
doesn't mean that it has disappeared.
Okay.
Praise the Lord. If you repent immorality, it doesn't mean that even those immorals
are supposed
to stop. Don't repent. And even immorality shall
stop.
Praise the Lord. Unless you yourself, you
will
say that I've discovered God doesn't want
immorality.
And you keep his word. The word says do not do sexual immorality. You shall find it wherever
you go.
You shall even find those immorality. And even at your place of work,
in different
places that you shall be, you
find it.
But the word that you kept in your heart,
it's
what shall stop you from sinning. No, it's not my be there when you haven't understood what it means. Amen.
It's
you who allow your heart to accept the word and say, do not commit adultery. God, I won't do it anymore. It's not that adulterers shall not be there. Out of the church to Johnny's place, you'll find them. Isn't it so? You said that it's the end of committing adultery. And even the adulterer shall text you. Praise the Lord. Because for you, when you repent adultery, it doesn't mean that it has gone. Praise the Lord. For it to remain there. But in you, when you've just
seen that way,
where it has been repressed into the word of God, the word that says do not commit adultery.
Flow.
Flo started singing that song, mom can remember. I think 2000. And she still wanted to record that song. Praise the Lord. On that day she was truly speaking it. She had heard the word. But at last she doubted it. Praise the Lord. And then she went back.
And
she went back in the word and moved
one.
And again she came back Now she has put the word back. So we want also to record that song. They record that
Atmos
Choir. Praise the Lord. The moment keep the word, and in the moment you go out of it, you will be taken away. Praise the Lord. It's not a man who remembers time and fill your audition for this life. It was 2000 and she wanted to record it. She wanted to record that song that appealed to what her heart. But problems intervened and things didn't go well. And they came through wedding. When wedding started from this place, and she also said, I want this generation. And when a man came, she also jumped onto him. And at the end, we looked for the word that she had kept, and it was no more. God should help us on this. If only God help us on this. And we understand the way where the church is right now. Jesus needs to release more grace onto church. You might not have understood. Jesus needs to pour more grace onto church. And let me tell you, Jesus doesn't get surprised if someone sins. No, it's not new to him. But wonders when someone refuses to repent. That's the one request. Praise the Lord. As I'm to count, I started from 2001. Right now we're 2021. So look at 2025 and more.
Stand back what it says so we
then. The people that the devil has used, that he has made to sin against God, you want to see them coming back to God. You want to see them coming back to God. Because Jesus is not his preparation to leave a sinner dying his sinning. And Satan does this, thinking that he wants to make Jesus, to make him lose everything that he did on the cross. Praise the Lord. That's why the Satan is not doing it for the money. He's doing it within the house. Praise the Lord. Jesus has a lot of scriptures here. He has read something to the church saying that when sin became more, that grace became
more.
Praise the Lord. When sin was much, when sin had hovered everywhere, so he brought up a stripe of grace and they said that's why Jesus doesn't get amazed or wonder. But Jesus wonders when he doesn't, you see people here in the voice, not hearing the voice that repent for your sin. Don't you see? Don't you see what happened to the church of Uganda? Someone now laughing at Tagalog. Why are you laughing?
What would you say?
Is there something funny? You who's laughing, are you an angel? If I talk, he sticks on his repentance. If he holds his repentance, he did the greater thing. For you think that it is ashamed, but he might have been rescued from destruction. And even the church to be worshiping. As you stood laughing at Ntagali and understood, you who haven't revealed how people do not know you, even the news did right about you, but the heaven is watching you. What he has been doing is what you're doing. So do what he did and also repent. The time we are in right now is to repent. That's the only stuff that hits the devil. As I look at Flo, I look at her and I see a lot of things. Do you also feel how when she's worshiping him? Because you might have seen her now, no problem. But for us, you have seen Flo from zero up to this moment. She has got a lot of lessons to learn. She's someone who has ever done every stupid thing on her soul. And she's someone who can face the love of Jesus and wonder. The being pastoring is easy. She has ever done everything stupid in this world. If only there were cameras on the road that recorded everything, but and even they bring up the pictures how she dressed. There are some people who used to come to me and say, you have seen your girl. You have seen her at 18. But the thing she's wearing, now she was serving them. Do you get me? Praise the Lord. But this scripture says, you people, the kingdom of God before you. Hello? Do you think he sent them to one another? But he knows that being aware, you want to see people. When they're coming to Jesus saying, have mercy on me. That's why we don't judge anybody. Praise the Lord. Because the grace of God, she's there, Flo is there, you can see her. That Flo is there. And every time I look at her, I see the grace of God in abundance. She was telling me, my husband. My husband wants to. I want to introduce my husband. Meaning that even during when he was coming home. So I thought this. Praise the Lord. So if you look at her, you cannot understand her now. She lays here worship. And you also feel it. If you haven't understood my wonder, is this God or no? What is real God? Saying when sin went, the grace was in abundance. Grace. Flawless. If only we had those cameras on earth. Flawless. If only we had them already. And they showed us at Eden. The pictures at Eden. There. And even how she used to dress. You would have known that God has got to forgive. You know that everybody who repents, God is going to forgive. I'm telling you the truth. But the grace of God is in abundance. That Jesus, you see, has a lot of grace. Let me tell you, Jesus is so graceful. They need to perform prayers. One after being married, and then they become stable. They get stable. I've seen everything now.
Unfortunately,
just let it be behind. You know, sometimes when mom insists on something, I don't deny. I say, let's go. So we drove and went there. And surprisingly, we saw her that day.
Before
she had gone in the Schneider and they
said
that she was going to die that exactly. Salvation is so precious. But if the devil steals the word from you, you can't understand it anymore. So we made her that day, and then we made her confess again. And that flood is there, you see. She starts poorly. She doesn't leave anything. She pours her heart. She comes to everything. And then she got saved again. And from that day when she got saved, it's the anointing that you see here flowing. So therefore, let us pray for each other. Let us not judge each other. Praise the Lord.
Do the right thing.
Do what you've given Christ to do.
Some
you've given the grace when you're powerful, you can overcome
nothing.
But there are also our fellows when sin is at work. So let us pray for each other with faith that people shall also repent. I've seen through repenting, she starts watching the heavens come down. So everybody can repent. So intercessors, when you're praying, let us pray for the spirit of repentance. Praise the Lord. I want to
corner
with this scripture. It's one I want to finish up with. In the book of Joshua, chapter 1 and verse 8. Joshua chapter 1 and verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way. From the beginning, if God is to walk with someone, you have to keep his word. Because Joshua was commanded the whole book of law. The whole book of law. He wanted to swallow it. To meditate upon it day and night. Keeping himself to walk as it is. Praise the Lord. The more he shall, praise the Lord. It's the one you shall be blessed. And even right now it's the same thing. That's why Jesus says in John 15, John 14, chapter 22, verse 23, that whoever has my commands and is the one who loves me. Whoever loves me is going to be loved by my Father, and I shall also love him. We shall come and make home in him. Hello? Does it differ from what was commanded to Joshua?
No.
No, it's not. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You cannot say that I'm in our Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord. But when you contradict with this command, you contradict with this word, the word will be out of your word. Your heart. So, Lord. And all of us, let us keep this word so that nobody makes you lose it. Hello?
Our
girls, young girls
here.
Those who are in the
middle age.
Girls have a new got married, there are temptations and different ways. Praise the Lord. And even these boys who have married, they're also confused, they have different problems. It can't be
in
a service that is. And it moves
out
without even getting anything.
Hello?
And then it's the same way to girls.
The
only man about the hairstyle. The only man about the hairstyle is my hair. My hair, right?
And then the
boys. You see them walking, you think they care a lot. That's why some have gone into marriage and don't perform well. Praise the Lord.
Because
in that time of being single, they didn't use it well. If you be serious to God, you also be serious to Him. There are certain things when they just have to
say,
when they just have to say to be following
God.
You want to only face destruction. Do you get what I'm talking about? You know this, your life is different. From them, they only mind about what they have. They only mind about where it sounds.
But you are easy.
They take everything easy.
Don't take it easy.
Don't take it easy. Build a relationship with God. Build a relationship with God. Even if it's nice
to
be, not every woman is yours. Pray to God to lead you to a right woman. And the one you won't regret after. And even girls, do not think that every man in the tribe is
yours.
And telling girls are now most stubborn, they go on to social media. Come here, one that God of this generation and boy. He has never met someone who lives in America. And he's saying, this one is my fiancé now. Praise the Lord. And these days they are saying that body organs are
coming.
Now this girl, they're going to meet him as a Russian man, an American guy. And this one says, now I've got they remove the organs and send them to get married. So things shouldn't be like that. Girls, you should humble yourselves. In these times of being single, it's very precious. You should use them. Praise the Lord. You seek God. And let me tell you, I don't believe that you have to go and look and seek for men. You go around, let me go to Miracle Center. Let me go to P5 and see for men. You want such of them. It shouldn't be like that. Praise the Lord. Do things knowing that you have the Spirit of God. Have the Word of God that controls your life. If the Holy Spirit gets filled with your life with His grace, the Holy Spirit shall bring the right man who will benefit you. Praise God. Praise God.
Our aim No, 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 no.
So it's not our aim to look for men who are going to marry us. No.
Katonda
mami. God knows you.
Mwara.
That you are a girl.
No, mwara wakula.
When a girl grows up, she gets married.
Afuno msanja na mwasa.
She gets a man who marries her.
Chino siki pie ni katonda.
This is not new to God. Praise the Lord.
Tukano kazi mwara we kumi le kutia katonda.
So you are saying, keep yourself in the fear of God.
Mwara kutu se.
The Holy Spirit to fill you.
Mwara kutu se.
Praise the Lord.
Use a favor.
To fill you with favor. You might find even a man can come as if he has come to pay a visit on different things. And the Holy Spirit tells him that. It's not a girl's business to seek for a man. Then let me seek for a man. I've seen a man who has dressed well there.
Wali yaba dawo mwala
In this area, there must be, that seems to be your wife. I got a vision. And in this area, there's your wife. Not everything they dream comes true.
Which is a little bit of a
just pray for it silently. But when you start coming to boys and say,
that
in this area here, for me once to get the best, when the Holy Spirit has prepared for us the right thing, praise the Lord. When your girl is not what you are on, and the guy comes to me and says, Irene, then what I'm saying, I want to marry you. Is the Holy Spirit going to intervene into your issues because you're going to get married? You must lay the relationship with the Holy Spirit from the ground before even you think of marriage. But all the time, whenever the
man comes,
he says, do not forget
what
he
can.
He says, do not do this, do the opposite. So you come to marry or be married, and then you ask him to answer. You've always been walking in spirit and they shall answer you. So let us walk in the word of God. I told you, walk in the word, you build a relationship with the Holy Spirit. So you ask him about my marriage, tell me about it. And he will say, I'm working to them. So you lift your hands. Praise the Lord. And you say, God, at this time, I don't care. You bring for me a man who understands
you.
Or a perfect man who understands you. Because if he doesn't understand you, everything shall be opposite. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So that's why we should keep ourselves. Let us have the fear of God in our souls. The Holy Spirit to be your friend. To put a hand on you. As I'm calling, let us learn this. There's no good man and there's no good woman. There's no bad woman and there's no bad man. Praise the Lord. But after the Holy Spirit has put his favor on to that woman is very, very beautiful. That man is very, very good. I don't know if you've understood. Because if the Holy Spirit puts his favor on you, they shall love you even if you, your legs are not straight. I don't know if you've understood. A man has to love you until you get old. Hello?
Hello?
He has to love you that old age. So he needs the power of
God.
God says that I'll place my feet upon you. Whenever he wakes up, he sees something new. And even a man when he's not possessed, praise the Lord. Year after year, if the Holy Spirit can do that through keeping his word, I've kept your word in my heart so that I don't sin. Is it the song that you shall sing? Alright? Hello?
No,
will you sing that song?
No,
will you sing that song?
No,
will you walk in it?
No, so
let us fight sin.
No,
so that will be established in one accord with the Holy Spirit. May God bless you with those words. Amen. And it's raining outside. Unless someone is sick,
please
stand up. Don't you pray, please stand up.
Amen.
Put your hands.
Mami,
ya
la
cosa,
doctor.
Mami,
ya
la cosa.
kukwasa naye nangirira obwoyo obwo okubakwata nekubalemesa okusalawo bakalaba bakalaba oli balabankana omwoyo ogwokulabankana ta obulamu bwabwe mu linnya lya Yesu ndagira amaanyi ag'ekizikiza agabalondola okuva ku bujjajja agabalondola okuva mu bikaga okukoca ndagira gabate mu linnya lya Yesu mwana wa Katonda omulamu ndagira batewe mu linnya lya Yesu myoyo okukaba wala njikuta obulamu bwabwe mu linnya lya Yesu nangirira amaanyi ga Katonda mukama gabeere nabo maanyi ag'omwoyo omutukuvu mukama gabeere nabo gabawe feva ey'ekisajja bawe omukisa emikono gyabwe nga bakola bawe sente emikono gyabwe mu linnya lya Yesu mwana wa Katonda kale grace mu ngalo zamani. Amen.